Hey everyone, Real with Wes here, back with day two of this week. And all week long, I'm gonna be talking about protecting your heart. Starts with Proverbs 4:23, where we talk about guard your heart above all else, because it determines the course of your life. And that's very important that we guard what gets on the inside of us, that we guard our belief systems, because it will govern our behavior, it governs our lifestyle, it governs how we shape the world and how we respond to things and how we maneuver through life. So it's really important that ultimately, yes, the Word of God is the prized thing that we need to focus on filling up our heart. But let me go back to what I was talking about yesterday, because I told you guys I talk about some stuff I really haven't shared on much of a public platform at all, by the way. I was dealing with that scripture that Paul talked about in Ephesians 4:26, be angry and sin not, which is, you can be angry, but don't let it lead you to sin. And we dealt with yesterday, if you didn't catch that, go back so I can, this is really part two, so you can connect everything. It's when your anger leads you away from trusting God. That's the big sin, really. It's, you know, we look at the outer manifestations of it, but it's when that anger leads you away from trusting God. Now you're trying to fix the problem on your own. Now you're trying to fix these issues apart from God and His wisdom and His word and faith and trusting Him. So, I told you I wanted to talk a little more personal where this comes from me. Most of you know I'm married, but before I ever met Nicole, of course, I have my son Jeremiah. He's 13 years old now, so that would put me roughly, you know, I had him when he was a little before I was 21. And, you know, I remember how things played out back then between his mom and I. And of course, you know, she sees this or anyone, this is in no way dishonor. I thank God for the mother of my child. I thank God for giving me one of the best gifts that ever showed up in my life, which was Jeremiah, our son. So this is in no way to do that. This is a teaching lesson for my personal life, though, is I remember while we were trying to sort things out, while we were trying to figure things out, there was a lot of hurt, there was a lot of anger, there was a lot of lashing out. There was just, you know, like anything, it was like, we weren't married, but it went bad as a really bad divorce, just about almost, to be honest. And I remember how all those things, how we handled each other and mishandled each other as our relationship ended, as, you know, as parents now, new parents that were trying to figure everything out, what was best for Jeremiah, what wasn't best for Jeremiah. And we didn't know how to handle it. And we made a lot of mistakes in that moment. But a lot of it came down to that part where I didn't understand, and I'm mostly gonna now talk from my perspective, I didn't understand how to guard my heart. Guard my heart to hate, guard my heart to anger, where although I was fighting for and us trying to figure out, you know, what's the best interest for our son in that moment in Jeremiah, it was easy because of the hurt and because of all the anger there and the things that I let get in my heart, be led astray from the original intent, which was what's best for our son. And we didn't always make the best decisions there because of that. We had to come back. I had to come back and clean up some things. I had to come back and deal with some stuff, because both of us had let this drive us to a certain place. I remember how I'd walk around and feel all the time when those things got in my heart so bad. I remember being angry just 24/7. I remember feeling hurt 24/7. I remember feeling stressed 24/7. And although I was pushing to be involved in my son's life, pushing to say, hey, this is what I believe what's best. And of course, she was pushing her side of what we both believed, you know, and when we had difference of what's best for how to raise our son as co-parents, even though, you know, things didn't work out between us. And I remember how I let certain things from our past and the way things ended get so far inside of me that it made me almost just blow a fuse every time. There were certain things that would just trigger me. I was not heading in a healthy direction personally. And at times, as bad as I was trying to fight to be the best dad I possibly could, I could get lost kind of in the mixture of everything, where it was trying to do the best decision, the right decision, but at the same time, it would get off track and we'd miss Jeremiah altogether. And that's what I want to kind of point out. I remember where there were times there was people that were in my corner, my own family members, where I'd be like so mad and be like, you can't understand, it's not your kid, it's not your, you know, and I'm saying some of this to my mom, and it's like, you don't understand how it is to deal with your son and trying to raise your son in the best interest, and I'm her son at the same time, but telling her, hey, you can't understand this, you don't know anything, da da da, and just being angry and pushing away even the people that were closest to me. And I became blind to some things. I almost became so jaded, and I was for a season of my life, where it just tried to consume everything on the inside of me. It tried to consume my world. It tried to consume all my relationships. It became a very broken place for me. And it really took Jesus to come in and heal me up. It took him putting a lot of people in my life along the road to heal me up, to heal those wounds, to heal those fractures, to heal the injuries that happened between my son's mom and I that we dealt to each other. It was a long road for that. But that's where a lot of this teaching will even come from, where I encourage you when it says, be angry and sin not. There was so much anger that I tried to handle the situation apart from God many of times. I tried to handle my son's mom from apart from trusting God and the wisdom of God is what it was. And it's more so it gave room to anger. It gave room to some bad decisions. It gave room to, you know, things not going the way it really could have the best way gone at times. And a lot's changed fast forward to 13 years, and I've learned a lot to be able to say that in a different position. So how does that, I gave my personal life a little bit, is to encourage you to guard your heart, to guard it from the wounds taking control of your life. The anger, see, it determines the course of your life. What are you letting determine the course of your life? It's not saying you can't feel hurt. It's not saying you can't feel angry. It's not let, but the thing we have to do and take our responsibility, I had to take my responsibility. I kept saying, well, maybe if my son's mom changes, maybe if this, and I couldn't wait for that day. And God finally said, it wasn't about her changing. It was always about you changing, man, because you can't do anything about that. You can only love her. It's my job to change her. It's my job to change you, and it's your responsibility to let me change you, Wes. And when I realized that, I realized I had to take charge for what gets in my heart. I had to be responsible no matter what was done, no matter the injustice that was done. I felt at times, no matter what the things I felt like I missed, you know, or I felt like a lash out and something, a special moment from my son was taken away from me and all those different things. I still had to be responsible for how I let it govern my life. Why? Because I have, even today, looking in hindsight, I have a wife to be responsible for. Imagine me being in such a toxic place, not able to love her the way she needs and deserves. Imagine me being in such a broken and toxic place. Now I can't do anything as a father for my son except fill him up with the same toxic thing. It's more than just you. It's more than just there. I realized so much it affected the people around me because I was not watching my heart well enough. I didn't understand how to do that. And that toxic stuff would spill all over and it hurt the people I loved the most. And see, that's what I don't want you doing. I want you to say, okay, I'm hurt. Okay, I'm angry. Okay, I got these things going on, but I'm not gonna let it control my life. I'm still gonna let the Word of God win out and control my life. I'm still gonna guard my heart. I'm still gonna govern some things. I'm still gonna do everything I gotta do to keep moving forward and believe in God. Even if I am angry, even if I am hurt, even if I'm going through the process of healing right now, I'm not going to let it govern my life. I'm gonna let the love of God govern my life. I'm gonna let the Word of God govern my life. And I'm gonna let the Spirit of God govern my life and watch God work you through it. Because God is a master at healing hearts. He's the healer of broken hearts. And there is nothing too broken that you can bring before Him that He won't so lovingly, masterfully, wonderfully put you back together and heal you, make you home. I love you guys, praying for you all. Like I said, each time I do one of these videos, if you need prayer requests or you got something going on in your life, leave a comment below, let me know. Even if you don't want to say what it's about, hey Wes, I just need prayer, and I'll shoot out a prayer for you is what I'll do. But I miss you guys, hope to get to see you soon, and talk to you later.